other school mom goes to community support, community schools are going to support that. I'm on another one, you know, to my lateral, that's not a couple offers, and I, you know, I don't need to turn all of that into one. And but I called them afterwards and said, "Oh, I'm going to need an offer, would you like to, you know, would you like to have lunch?" And you know, they're really fond of that. I met another one, CLE at all days, who, you know, had a negotiation with CLE, we have a partner, you know, in negotiation, that was old news, which are going to be, you know, a powerful partner for our first day, let's teach them that. And so these are folks that, you know, we can meet anywhere, you know, just at any point in time, you just have to be really aggressive about it, because they're not going to have to, people like exposure, they like feeling wanted, especially, you know, if because you present yourself as someone who's like worthy of helping as well. And these are people who are very attractive, where you're like, "Yeah, you know, why not? You'll be happy at drinks, and you can, you know, doing whatever I do in the day, which probably isn't that interesting, but, you know, it's good time to hang out with people." I think also, you know, as a counterpoint to my Calvin type, I never use my mentors as a way to get a job. And I think I decided this because I think it puts them in a very awkward position. I think that's something to be careful of as well, is that, you know, the mentor-mentee relationship is not as straightforward in the sense of like, "Oh, because you can say whatever." A lot of times you can say whatever, and that's part of the reason why my mentors say, because you have an emotional connection. It's not, you know, the formal mentor-mentee, you know, relationship that a kind of friend has after you invite someone to your talk. But I mean, I have never used any of my mentors for to lead to another job. I think what I use them for instead is kind of career guidance about things that you might not be that happy about for a career firm, but that would be for me. Because there's something like, you know, I am bringing in a client, but I don't know, you know, what partnership or this product client. You know, how do I go about asking these questions without, you know, alerting people in the firm that, "Oh, by the way, like, you don't have this opportunity, you're not going to have that," you know, finding each other for this opportunity. And so it's things like that where I think that can be very useful as well.
Actually, that's not a question, but to turn back to the mentors or questions, sorry about that. So the first thing that I was like, I've been practicing for a few years now. What I find most of with mentor relationships at firms or outside of firms, you have to make the relationship work. I think what happens a lot, mentees sort of want, you know, expect the mentors to do the work, help me, you know, teach me, show me. And I think that they're willing to do that, but you have to sort of make the first overtures and kind of almost make them take ownership, you know, have them take ownership of you by always being in front of them. And I think then you can make it work, and I think it takes away some of the frustration that especially younger attorneys feel, because it feels one-sided and they don't know how to take this to the next level, i.e. not just the lunch that they provide value. The other thing that I found really helpful, this was just last year, I think it was after your audience, another one of these panels, and one of the speakers made a distinction between having mentors and sponsors. And, you know, a sponsor is like someone who's at the place that you work, who's going to help you get that promotion or figure out how to grow your career within that institution. And they're going to beat the table for you, you know, at a partnership meeting or whatnot. And they're going to fight through. And that person can be an officer, should be different from a mentor. Who you mentioned, you know, you're seeking more for general advice and emotional connection or like guidance, and so you sort of get rid of that awkwardness, and like, "Okay, you're my mentor, I share a lot of things with you, but now also do this, you know, now also do this for me." And one of the things that I've learned is that there's certain communities, I think, that have a harder time getting a sponsor, because we don't like to ask. We don't like to ask people to fight for us in an institution, but that's sort of how you're going to make inroads. And it doesn't have to be a very blunt ask, but you know, sort of ways to match the conversation. But I think if younger attorneys sort of have that dichotomy in their head, you can really make people who have been doing this for longer than you be an asset and not always wonder, "Well, how am I going to well, how do I make this relationship work? And I was like, well, why is it not helping me? Because I find a lot of people say that and, you know, feel that way, and it's almost like the sense of entitlement, but it's a two-way street.
And so to follow up on what you said, you kind of like young is kind of having this conversation because they're always referring young people to you. Some of them have been wonderful. Some of them, we said the problem, we talked about this with an avenue for us to be mentoring. And I said, well, what is the problem? Some of the young people are misconstruing what you're saying, the role of mentor and mentee, and literally stopping the board members. You know, I will reach out to you on an email, but I have a day job, I'm busy. And they'll be coming at me, you didn't answer me, you didn't do this, you didn't do that. And I'm trying to teach them that, and you're taking it. That's not going to work with me, okay? I'm very, very giving, I'm very kind, I love to share. And any office that I work in, they always say, Mike, it's the middle, the she's Switzerland. She pulls the senior people together with the team, okay? And I do. When I interview for jobs, I'll tell them, I'm a good team player, I'll pull top to bottom, we'll all roll together, and it'll work. However, you know, when junior people come into me, I'm not going to do your job, I'll tell you how to write it, blah, 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 blah. But I have a lot of colleagues come in, could you write this for Mike? I'm not going to do your work, okay? And they do consider me their mentor because a lot of them wanted to go to law school. And I will guide you and advise you, but, you know, just gotta, and it's interesting what you said, because my mentors, I never ask them for a job. You know, they will lift the phone, maybe, okay, and I don't never want to disappoint them. They're older than me, some of them, I work really hard for them. Sometimes I feel like I want to make them proud. So I'll call them if I'm frustrated at a job, the corporate food chain is getting to me, I'm reaching the ceiling, what do I do? And they're always guiding me and advising me, I'm doing the same thing. But you know what it is? They always say, Margaret, you're the one that's got to do it. You've got to make yourself shine. We're going to advise you. And, you know, it does. It gives you a great comfort level. At the end of the day, because sometimes you're very frustrated, you know, we are smart attorneys. We are senior, but sometimes the system just gets to you. You know, a lot of times, sleep deprivation, after getting some sweat lunch, and you're questioning yourself. So I know when I'm in the office and I'm going to question myself, I literally will get up and laugh, right? Because these methods are in my industry. What do you think? Am I taking the right approach? And, you know, that really helps guide me through the storm.
Yeah. I'll just say this. This really shows the importance of mentors. I came from government, and virtually everybody in my suite has been my adversary. And now they're my mentors, because I have very good relationships with my adversaries. And just yesterday, I got a call on my BlackBerry, which is also my office phone, from somebody saying that his nephew's in central booking. I've never set foot in criminal court in my entire life. So I ran over to somebody, of course, I was pretty nervous, to somebody that I knew, who I knew to criminal work, and I said, hey John, this guy called me up and said that he's central booking, you can bet you can help this guy out. And he saw that I was nervous, he was amused, and he says, Joe, you can do this case, I'll walk you through it, go over there. And it didn't end up working out because I guess they had a realization that there were three lawyers available in criminal court, and I wasn't one of them. But you know what, next time, who knows, somebody that's that willing to help me out, because I have a relationship with them, he could get me somebody that could be a very good source of business for me. And I have several mentors, and they're really indispensable because as a solo, I don't have any supervisors anymore, and it's pretty nerve-wracking. And I have had those situations, and they have been very much available to guide me and to help me do my job effectively.
Does anyone have any more questions for the speakers or comments or general musings?
I think that some of this is going to come out a little afterwards, so if you have any questions, you can ask them in private.
May I
just
do the recording once?
Yeah.
Those of you who don't know me, my name is Yang Chen. I'm the executive director of Avni, and I want to thank all the speakers in the panel, Jason, Calvin, Vincent, Margaret, Vanessa, and Angie for moderating it. For those of you who are not members, if you are here to join, we actually have current copies of our newsletter, The Advocate, and on the back cover is the membership form. And for those who are in transition and maybe have hardship in paying the dues, we actually have social membership is $3 a year, which we use. We do encourage you to join. We have a lot of great programs like this, both substitute programs that help you get ahead in your career, as well as networking events where you can network. We'll do it right after. And some upcoming events, we have about five committees represented here, but the way to get active non-committee is to get involved in committees. So next week alone, we have a few committees that we have. We have the LIT committee, we have the pro bono committee, we also have the IP committee having a first meeting. And I know that one of the councilmen has talked about her upcoming event.
I don't know how much you're interested in change. And actually, one of our speakers is actually one, it's a state, changes in the state taxes. But the reason that you should come out here on this panel is because there'll be a lot, 100 attorneys that are alive. I'm trying to get it, because you didn't have a lot of things, but I got it.
So, the populist program is going to jump their career, how to make right moves, and we think the best way to do it is to get active and involved in the source of stuff. This one, where we have our different committee, so no matter if you're just starting out, making changes in your career, the best way to do it is to meet the people who are actually doing what you want to do. And you may not want to move now, but as some of the panel said, the best time to look for a new job is when you really have one. Yeah, you don't wait until you have to bang that mentor's door or that person in your network you have to talk to for years. So this is what Avi's about. This is your network, and we urge you to plug into it, to use it, because that's what it's for. So I want to thank you for the panel again. Welcome you all for coming. Thank you all for coming. And stay around, and you know, we'll talk to you. Thank you.